Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, and here rendering an exposition of Matthew 16:21-28. From that time on, Jesus began to explain to his disciples, they were not disciples, they were laborers, that he must go to Jerusalem, that he wanted to tell them, you know, that now I have emptied myself and now is ready time for to go to Jerusalem and suffer many things at the hands of the elders, chief priests and teachers of the law, that he must be killed and on the third day be raised to life. Now he tries told him forecast that now I have emptied myself, I have told you what I want to tell you, and now I want to go back to my Father, and before I go to back to my Father, I want to lay my life as the Lamb of the God, so that the hearts of the people be cleansed, that I, being an innocent man, these cruel people have killed me. So there's no speck of doubt left in the minds of the people that the temple priests, they are cruel people, merciless, without light of God in them. That's full of darkness. And Christ Jesus came to give them light, as is stated by John, that Christ Jesus, the light came among his own. They rejected the light in preference to darkness. So that was the temple priest did. So then Jesus, after this, you know, then he wanted to go back to Jerusalem to give his sacrifice. So he predicted his death. But Peter did not know what he is talking about, because he was once born. Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. So Peter said, because he had been given, you know, that in the previous, that Peter has told him that you are the Christ of the living God. And Jesus had told him, unless my Father gave you, you can't have it. So he became arrogant. Hey, I have no gospel now. And so he became arrogant and said, you know, how can it happen to you? You are not going to die because you make the people who are dead living. So miracle he has seen. So Peter did not know that anybody who is born is to die, and Christ Jesus being the very Spirit of God, he knows where from he came and how he is going to die. Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. Never Lord. He always used to address Jesus as Lord because he was once born, not twice born. As people in the churches, they do address Jesus as Lord and God. They are once born stones. These dog-colored people, they turn them into bread. He said, this shall never happen to you. Jesus turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. You are a stumbling block to me. You do not have in mind the things of God, but the things of men. That means he doesn't understand the things of God, that whosoever is born is to die, and his fate is written, predestined by our Father. So he said, you know only the things of men, that I make the people dead living, and how can I die myself? Then Jesus said to his disciples, they were not disciples, they were laborers, If anyone would come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. Now this in Jesus, you know, we do not follow anyone, but we go after the light. So Jesus said, if anyone who wants to go after the light which I have given, they should be careful that these people of this world will hate them. And they should be prepared to lay down their life for gospel truth. Remember the gospel, Christ Thomas went to India and over there he preached gospel. But the local Brahmins, they did not like to have their domination to be taken over by Christ Thomas. So he was killed, you know, by those local Brahmins for overtaking their dignity or situation. For whoever wants to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for me will find it. That means people think, you know, that living in this world is comfortable, and why should I speak something which upset the others? Gospel is a winnowing fire. It is not something which is sweet. It is a bitter tablet. And when you preach gospel, many people don't like it because they think this man is annoying us or is doing something opposite what we have been told in the churches. So they don't want to know gospel. They are quite happy. And if you are not careful, and if you are in a hostile country, like in Asia, you know, if you go there, what I preach here, if I preach in India, people would beat me. So here is the West is the place where people can listen and there is a freedom of speech. So that's why Jesus is saying, you know, for whoever wants to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for me will find it, because we are Christ of our living Father God. So when you become Christ of the living Father, you become like your fathers. Unless you are son of God, you cannot preach gospel. So son of God are eternal like our Father, so he will find salvation. What good will it be for a man if he gains the whole world, yet forfeit his soul? That means we come here for the salvation of our soul. And if we can't salvage our soul and go after material wealth, to please the people, to earn the praises of the men, what good it is? No good. Man comes and dies, born and dies, and then he takes rebirth. So this is the best time to earn salvation, because this is the age of Christ. What can a man give in exchange for his soul? Soul is invaluable. Nothing can buy, money can't buy soul. Have you seen these surrogate mothers producing children? They are doing a lot of favor to the people, because you can't buy a living child with money. So what is of God inside the flesh you can buy, but the soul inside, you cannot pay for it. For the Son of Man is going to come in his Father's glory with his angels, and then he will reward each person according to what he has done. Remember that Christ Jesus paid the wage to his laborers at Pentecost in the parable of a vineyard. Certain man had a vineyard, he planted a wine press in the middle. Alright? So the husbandmen were the temple priest who became inefficient, corrupt. So they were thrown out. So Christ Jesus come to make us to work in the vineyard of our Father. Some he employed early morning, some late. In the evening the master of the vineyard come, who is God. He asked the foreman, bring your laborers and pay them. So foreman Christ Jesus then paid them their wage. So same is this, we are also expecting our wage from our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus, the foreman. I tell you the truth, some who are standing here will not taste death before they see the Son of Man coming in his royal kingdom. So Jesus predicted, you know, that these people who are standing here, they will see me back coming into this word. And God, our Father, bless.